begin exploring families, let's select the sofa component in the living room. Next, open the family editor to see the component definition. Now we can examine all of the component's parts to see how they were made. Select the coffee table, which will then allow us to edit the extrusion. The coffee table was made by extruding a square sketch up from the ground. Now select the side table and open the Edit Extrusion tool. This table was also made by extruding a rectangular sketch above the ground. Next, select the backrest. This time we are given the option to edit a sweep. This portion of the sofa was made by running a sketch along a chosen path. Let's open a family not included in our model and examine it in depth. In the File menu, choose to open a family. Let's choose the shaker bed for this example. Now we can examine how the parts of this component were made. After selecting the headboard, footboard, and mattress, we can see that they were all made from extruding various shapes off of various planes. Now let's open the Family Types dialog. From here, we can select different types of the family in order to examine their parameters. Each type has different dimensions assigned to it. They can also be assigned different materials and finishes. Now let's modify this family to fit our needs. First, save the file as a new family so we don't overwrite the original. Name the new file Bed 4 Post. To begin, let's remove the rail on the headboard. Select the rail, then select Delete. Now let's change the pattern of holes on the headboard. Select the headboard and edit the extrusion. Now, switch to an appropriate elevation to edit the sketch. Select the boundary lines and move them into the desired location. Finish the sketch and return to the 3D view to see the changes. Instead of editing or deleting existing forms, we can also add new forms to a family. Select the reference level. And under the Home tab, open the Extrusion tool. Now, let's sketch a square that will be extruded to create one of the posts for our bed. When done, select the check mark to finish the extrusion. When done, select the check mark to finish the sketch. Notice that the extrusion starts at 0 feet and rises to a height of 1 foot. Change the extrusion end to 7 feet to extend the height. Now we can select the extrusion and open the Materials dialog. Assign the post the same material as the frame and select OK. Now, in the reference view, let's mirror the bed post over the center axis to place another post on the other side. Finally, copy these two posts to the other end of the bed. Now, return to the 3D view to see our finished bed. Open the family types and choose a new type to make sure our constraints are still satisfied. In the Family Types dialog, we can also create new types. Under Names, we can see the types already created. Click New, and let's name our new type California King. For this new type, we can now choose a new length and width. Our new type will appear with the other types, and we can apply our new type to the model. When finished, let's save the family in order to keep our changes. To place this component, let's switch to our model. Select Place a Component. Notice that our new component is not available as a type. Open the Load Family dialog and find our bed in the library. Now, place an instance into the model. After selecting the bed, we can change it to a different type in order to get a more appropriate size. We can then select the bed and edit its type properties in order to change parameters such as the materials used.